So Hayden, New Zealand, are you bit of controversy around its name? A lot of people want to change it back to its original name, but some people might claim that it's not its original name, the word Aotearoa.
Oh wow, we're just walking from one controversy right into another controversy. So what do you th are you're asking me,
Yeah,
would I rather our country be called New Zealand or Aotearoa?
or the same or both or either.
Look at me, G. You got me
It's
flustered.
so bad I wanna shoot like hoops while I'm riding in the coupe. I got what you want, it ain't nothing but a loop. Don't listen to friends, they don't know what's best for you. I want you, yeah, bad I wanna shoot like hoops while I'm
Welcome back,
riding in the
everybody,
coupe.
to the Below Average Podcast. My name's Hayden. I'm here with my buddy Christian. And Christian, episode 2. We made it.
Mama, we made it.
Mama, we made it. It was about much more than 3 views than we thought we were going to get, Christian. We didn't think we'd get over 200 views. We didn't think we'd get over 20 subscribers. So just thank you guys. Thank you guys for the views, for the subscribes. Special shout out to everybody who shared the channel on your page. And thanks for subscribing, thanks for liking, thanks for commenting. It helps. It actually does help with the algorithm. Helps us push the page out. So yeah, thanks to everyone that shared the page. And if you're watching this, you can share this video on your Facebook, share it with your friends, like, comment, subscribe. And yeah, it helps a lot. You can find us on this page. There's our email in the on our page. You can find it in the description, I think, or in our bios. Special shout out to Reddit user Chosen One 42069. On Reddit. You can find us on Reddit, by the way, below underscore average underscore boy. Special shout out to the Reddit subreddit r/New Zealand for banning us permanently, Christian. We got banned permanently on r/New Zealand. And r/Wellington took our post down, so shout out to you guys. We're gonna remember you. We're gonna remember it. I think it's good for us to explain the channel, Christian, because we kind of kicked the door in with a heavy topic, religion. I think it's we didn't really explain this channel very well, so I think we should explain it for our subscribers and any potential viewers out there. And tell them what this channel is really about.
Yeah. I'm on this new contract where I get paid per word. So I'm trying to keep my words down limited so Hayden doesn't have to pay me so much.
Oh no. How much did you say just then? I can't afford that. Yeah, no. This channel, because I know it was kind of controversial, our first episode. Kind of came out of nowhere. We're just two random boys who came out of nowhere, said some really controversial stuff. But I want everyone watching to understand we don't mean to be offensive.
It's just a joke, really.
It's a joke. It's like we're trying to mix jokes in with our thoughts and just
Just letting know the people on film behind the camera that I see them.
Yeah. And this the name says it all. We called this channel Below Average for a reason. This channel is for, there was a niche we saw on YouTube. We don't really see any average New Zealanders have a say in the world. There's only famous people kind of putting their opinion out there. So we thought, why not make this channel to kind of let the world know the average Kiwis view on the world. So That's what this channel is about. That's what this podcast is about. It's just two nobodies talking about anything and everything. And that's why it's so important for everyone watching to subscribe and comment down below. Let us know what you think. Ask us questions, you know.
What we should cover next.
Yeah. Let us know what you want us to talk about, because this is your guys' channel just as much as it's our channel, you know. It's really important to comment. So yeah, that's pretty much what we're plugging now. You can comment down below or talk to us on Reddit. We don't have any other social media. We will in the future, but for now, it's baby steps.
And hey, if you see Hayden out in the streets and you want to approach him with a question, come up to him and ask him a question. It's fine.
Yeah, literally, like, it's anything you guys want to talk about in the comments is fair game. We won't censor anybody unless you say something really crazy. But
or pick on us.
Or pick on or hurt our feelings. But no, you can, the comment sections are there. We want everyone to engage in this channel. And no question is a bad question. If you disagree with us, that's fine. But we'll address it on the show. If you have a question, good or bad, pop it down there and me and Christian will answer as best that we can. Isn't that right, Christian?
Yep.
Oh, damn, that's... Now I've got to pay you another $5 to you. $5 a word.
$5 a word, man. Shit. I'll just start repoing things. And then as the video goes on, and you just start missing.
Yeah, my computer's gone.
Towards the end of the fucking episode, you're just sitting in a
just
fucking...
Just one camera.
No t-shirt on. There's not even the camera anymore. It's that little camera above your screen.
Yeah, it's this one. Speaking of, yeah, guys, any comment, any question you have, we'll answer it. And we actually did have a question from a subscriber, Christian. Plan BZ. I have his question right in front of me because I had to write it down. Plan BZ's question to us, Christian. Mm-hmm. He says, "Sup, brothers, haha, do or watch your beliefs on what happens to you in death." I'm guessing he just means, what do we believe happens when we die? I'll let you take it away first, Christian.
Yeah, just die, mate. You're just dead. You're just a body and a coffin. Put him in a coffin.
People used to say that. You know, Plan BZ took time out of his day, Christian, to type in, ask us a question. Thank you, Plan BZ, for your question, by the way. Took time out of his day. He's probably sitting there like, wow, guys, thank you for the insight. You just die.
Yeah, you die. Put him in a coffin, and then you go on the ground.
Yeah. I mean, I agree with Christian wholeheartedly.
Yep.
You know, what happens after you die, pretty much almost instantly after you die, depending on what you wanted to happen to you, you go in the coffin, you go underground, and family members do a haka.
And people, enough of that, people might come and see you once every
couple of years, you know, reminisce, put a Facebook post up.
Yeah.
Or you get cremated. That's the physical stuff. I'm assuming you want to know what we think happens to you spiritually. We kind of covered in the first episode our feelings on that sort of stuff. Christian is 50-50 on ghosts, so you think he's going to be a spirit?
A ghost, man. I don't know. I don't think it's like human ghosts. I think it's like... How can you explain it, you know? Fuck, I don't know.
What do you mean?
I don't know if they're spirits or not. I just think they could be creatures created.
Oh, yeah. I get what you mean. Kind of like your essence.
Yeah.
After you pass over.
Nah, not even our essence. Just like a creature created, you know?
And that's what, like, ghosts are, technically. The ones that get caught in, like, insane asylums and...
Fuck, I don't know. Actually, now I just want to say, no, ghosts don't believe. I don't believe in ghosts.
He backtracked, everyone. Go back to the thing. Clip the first episode. Yeah. Clip the first episode. Cushed him. You got him, guys. You backtracked.
You got me. We got him.
We got him. I mean, on my part, you know, I don't believe in ghosts or afterlife or none of that. I just think it's all just darkness. It everything will just be gone. I kind of explained it in the first episode. It's just, you're pretty much asleep, but it's the part of your sleep that you don't remember. But thank you for your comment, Plan BZ. And anyone can comment. That's what this channel is about. It's about us. We're just two nobodies. We're not famous. And we know you're a nobody watching this. So come in. Comment down below. Join the discussion. This is what this channel is about. We want people to... We won't censor you. You can literally ask anything and we'll give you the below average perspective. The average Kiwi perspective. Because... famous people don't know. They're not down in the trenches with us. They don't know what reality is. You know what I mean? Anyone can comment. We actually want you to comment. Because we have no content. And we need content. Yeah. Please. Please comment. So that's basically the...
gist of it.
Channel. The gist of the channel. Just two below average boys talking about... anything and everything, and you can join the conversation too. Just comment down below and we'll read your comments on the podcast and we'll answer as best we can. You can ask us about anything.
But we don't be drunk for the next one? Because right now we're sober as well.
Yeah, we're sober just because I drank last night and Christian's a bit under the weather.
But that last video, we weren't drunk, we're like...
No, we weren't drunk. We.
But nah, it was enough to fucking.
Yeah, it was just
yabber on about fucking. Yeah. We're not like that, and like all the time.
I think the more episodes we do, the better we'll be at getting drunk, doing it
with no filters. That's all that the alcohol helps is just
take the filter off.
Yeah.
By the way, if you comment, if you're a subscriber, you're part of this podcast, so. Let us know and Christian will tell you why you're stupid. No, I'm kidding.
So, Hayden, New Zealand, are you bit of controversy around its name? A lot of people want to change it back to its original name, but some people might claim that it's not its original name, the word Aotearoa.
Oh, wow. We're just walking from one controversy right into another controversy. So... what do you think? You're asking me.
Yeah.
Would I rather our country be called New Zealand or Aotearoa?
Or the same, or both, or. Either.
Huh. Look at me, G. You got me flustered. You know, last episode, I was just like, this is my thought. No. But this one. I don't know. Do I prefer Aotearoa or New Zealand? I prefer Aotearoa, right? Because that was the original name. But if someone from another country came over here and to my face said, fuck New Zealand.
Yeah.
I'll be honest.
You'll be mad?
Yeah, it'll get me in my heart.
You're big mad, eh?
So, like, I'm down for both of them. Just like... here's where I am on that, actually. I don't mind it being called New Zealand or Aotearoa. I just mind it when someone who wants it to be New Zealand says don't call it Aotearoa.
Yeah, on the comment section.
Yeah, like, fine, you want it to be New Zealand, don't try... And even Maoris, don't say, no, New Zealand. Like, I grew up with it as New Zealand, and I love our country. It's one of the reasons we started this channel, so... on both sides, I don't think we have the right to say.
Yeah, true.
You can't call it that.
Absolutely.
So that's my take on that. What would I rather it be called?
Yeah.
I'd rather it be called Aotearoa.
Yeah.
But I'm not gonna sit there and be like, Like, if someone besides me says, I want it to be called New Zealand, I'm not going to be like, no.
And your take on the flag, what do you reckon? Change it or keep it the same?
These are very good questions, Christian. I'd rather it change to the Māori flag, to be honest.
You reckon? Yeah. Yeah, that makes more sense to me. I wouldn't even be mad if they just kept the four stars. I just don't think we need, like, the Great British Flag, the Union Jack up there.
Yeah, it's basically the... Yeah, I'd rather it be the Māori flag, to be honest. Yeah.
Well, why do we need the Welsh, the Scottish, and the English flag?
Yeah, I mean...
On our flag, you know?
This is Aotearoa.
Yeah,
and I'm not saying that it should just be Aotearoa, but at the end of the day, this country is a Māori country.
Oh shit, gee, you just like shook a bush right there.
Yeah, we're walking into controversy again. We try to tiptoe around controversy today, but it's I don't see why we should have the Union Jack.
Yeah.
For some reason, I feel like this is way worse than our first episode.
Nah, it's true though. I don't think... Why the hell do we need it there? I guess we're in the Commonwealth, but like still, that's a bit...
And I feel like it's just...
It's not original, eh? It's not us.
Yeah, it is. It's kind of just showing who we're under.
Yeah.
And I'm really... And it's funny because I'm pretty much a plastic Māori, right? But I'm so proud to be a Māori. And like, I don't know. I wonder if anyone in the comments, I wonder if foreigners see us as Māori first, or if they see us as a British.
Nah, I think they see us as a British. Fisk, and I don't want to use the other.
Yeah,
because my missus is not from here, and she said, oh, when I thought of New Zealand, I just thought a whole bunch of Fisk and people just walking around for a whole bunch of British people.
Yeah, like, it does kind of do my heart a bit sad knowing that people, when they first see New Zealand, they think it's just an offshoot of England, of the British Commonwealth. And their first thought isn't, oh, that's where Māoris are.
Mm.
Like, that's not their first thought.
Oh, yeah, original people, yeah.
And
people,
I feel like if the country was named Aotearoa, then people would be like, what's that? What's that language?
Yeah.
Then, it's Māori.
But, like, yeah, it's a bit of a... But we don't get, like, hate for this.
I feel like we'll get a bit of hate for this, but I mean...
But it's just going to be a whole bunch of, like... Old people, bro, that use, like, a picture of their cat on Facebook, gee.
We don't speak Māori.
What is Māori? What is Aotearoa, bro? And then you click on their picture, and it's just, like, a lady with their picture of her cat with three likes, or some old fucking waste of oxygen-looking guy.
By the way, I don't speak Māori. I don't speak...
Te reo Māori.
Yeah, I don't speak... A lick of te reo Māori, but I'm still proud to be Māori.
Yeah.
And I just feel like, you know, it doesn't have to be changed from New Zealand to Aotearoa, but I feel like it just gives us a bit more... Yeah,
originality.
Originality, yeah.
Yeah. But I can see, like, a comment right now. There's all these comments from, like...
I'm trying to be nice about it. I'm trying to be really nice about it.
Or they'll be like, that podcast you just made wouldn't happen if we didn't come here.
Yeah, that's what they thought. You would still be in the dirt.
Yeah, you guys would be filming with a fucking...
You'd be filming with a fucking kakapo. Oh, man.
You still have a fucking fire to signal?
Yeah.
Bro, people gotta wake up. Like, the way they think like that is like, you know how there's those Pacific Islands, right?
Yeah.
And they're not like that, and they're just all Pacific Island people. They're not still living in the dirt and blah, 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 blah.
For instance, Samoa is called Samoa.
Yeah.
Tonga is called Tonga. I just kind of wish our native country was called our native language, you know?
100%. And I don't think we'd still be playing with fucking sticks.
Yeah, we would have evolved. Like, yeah. Not to this standard, maybe, but no. We would have evolved. Yeah. Like, to just assume that... No, but yeah, I need to stress that because I feel like because of the first episode, I don't want to be too controversial. I'm not backtracking. We will never backtrack on this fucking channel, by the way. These are our proper thoughts. We're just trying to let you guys understand where our thoughts stand. Like, I just feel like it Aotearoa.
Yeah.
I understand there's people that will say, no, it's New Zealand.
Mm.
But, like, pretty sure it's Aotearoa first.
But then you'll get people that will be like this. But Aotearoa, that's not even what all Māoris called it. Only a certain group of Māori would have called it Aotearoa. Because this is from that origin of that place.
Yeah.
So why would we borrow? I know people that are like that.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's what they said to me when I said that to certain someone. They're like, not all Māoris call it Aotearoa because that doesn't originate from where they are. That's from up here in Northland. You know, because have you ever been like just standing there and there's just that one big long cloud that goes all across the, the far north?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, that's what they reckon. But hey, at least it's a Māori word.
Yeah.
Hayden, what do you think of our Prime Minister and our government?
Honestly, I just don't think of them.
Do you vote, Hayden? Let the people out there know.
Should I let them know if I vote?
Yes.
Man, should I let them in? That's... Do I trust you guys? Do I trust you guys the information?
Did you vote for the weed referendum? When they done that? Did you vote for it or no?
I did.
You did? Oh, good man.
But I'm not gonna... you guys don't... You know what? 1,000 subscribers, I'll tell you what I voted for in the
weed referendum. I voted fucking yes.
Well, you're just going to give yourself up like
that? I won't give myself up like
that. Bro, give them little nibbles to you. Let them just dangle bait.
Yeah, but I voted yes for... but I just couldn't believe that they passed to let people kill themselves. Like, I voted yes for that as well.
Yeah.
If they, you know, in pain and agony.
Oh, what's it called? Euthanasia.
Yeah. Like,
whew. That passed... Bro, you are just on controversy. Bro, you're just driving down controversy road right now.
That's crazy. It's crazy. But anyway, back to our government. Auntie Jacinda, what do you think of her?
I'll just give my thoughts on politicians in general.
Yeah.
I don't trust any of you motherfuckers. I don't know them. I don't trust you guys. Like, it's not even like a personal... it's not even whether I agree with their policies or not. Mm. It's just like, I feel like all of them stand in front of the camera. And that's one of the reasons we made this channel. They stand in front of the camera and say what they want, or what they think we want to hear. We will never say what we think you guys want to hear. We're going to say what we think.
Yeah, that's true.
And if it jives with you, it jives with you. If you don't like it, you don't like it. But I just feel like politicians kind of stand there, smile, and like... they're just untrustworthy. I don't trust any of them.
Shit.
So in terms of Jacinda, you know.
But like, you know, there's not. I'm gonna say, yeah, I voted for Jacinda twice.
Yeah.
Like, who you know? Because the other guy, he's pretty churchy. Yeah, he's pretty religious.
Oh, what's his name?
Luxon.
Oh yeah.
Is that his name? Yeah. Like, I don't know.
Wait. Did you not vote for him because he's churchy?
Nah, and there was another guy there, I can't remember what his name, he used to wear the fucking Make America Great Again hat. It's like, it's just weird people, bro. And I thought she was like, they're all clowns, but she was the least worst clown.
Yeah.
But everybody wants to blame someone for why we fucked up.
See, like, is she the least worst clown, or is she just better at acting like she cares?
Yeah, like she cares. But then again, I think we would have been in the state we are right now, regardless of whatever happened. It's like what Thanos said. Say it, Chief. You know the word he says, eh?
Nah.
Fuck, I'm going to say it, but you can, like, voice over me and put, like, the actual way.
Oh.
Inevitable. It's inevitable.
Oh, inevitable. Inevitable,
yeah. See enemy.
See enemy. Yeah.
Yeah, gee, fuck, I can't pronounce words to save my life. Yeah, we're fucking retards. And so what?
We're below average. Yeah. We did below average at school.
Yeah, we accept that with some things we can't pronounce. But can you?
Achieve is a pass.
Yeah.
Yeah, in terms of politicians, I honestly feel like if they stood there and told me they cared about me,
yeah,
it would just be all cap.
It's all just trying to build their own profile. Yeah,
they're trying to get their rep up. They're trying to get their guys in the seats.
Line their pockets.
And we will never do that to you guys. We will always say what we truly think. Because we don't care what you think. We care what you ask. And we will try our best to interact with all of our subscribers, all of our viewers, all of our commenters. But we will never sit here and try to sweet talk you guys into liking us.
You kind of want to make this like channel about like what's happening in New Zealand at this very moment.
Yeah, this channel is, yeah.
So let us know about what you think of all these New Zealand farmers that are kicking up a stink about we grow the food, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, I 100% agree with you. And then like, what's happening? Have you seen any of that on?
I only saw the fart tax stuff. I think that's fucking stupid.
Yeah, that's crazy stupid.
I think that's stupid that the government wants to tax farmers on farts.
Bro, how they don't know how much a cow farts? So they don't like put a balloon on their ass every day and it just blows up, and then they put it into this tank and then they like put the pressure gauge on, like, yeah, your cow's farted this much.
A balloon with measuring things. Just a guy out there, just every morning you wake up, you just come out, fog coming out of your breath, you just get the fart count. You have to hire a guy. Hey, if anyone needs to hire someone to count farts,
I'm your guy.
I'm your guy.
Boy, that's going to be crazy. I don't know how.
Now, I'm not a farmer, so I don't really stick that close, but hey, I'll tell you right now, fart tax came across my desk. You know, I caught wind of that. You know, puns, bro. But you are a farmer, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm a hobby farmer. I guess I call myself that.
So what's your views on the current climate of what the government's doing with farmers, and are they doing a good job or a bad job?
But like, I think my ICS is going to be like, if this ever makes a big, people don't look back and be like, you're a fucking dickhead for saying that. But I think it's like, people just love to winch, bro.
Oh, wow, you're going against the grain.
No, it's like, I'm with them, but then again, it's like, people love to whinge, bro. Like, I guess the prices are going up. There's people in this country that are broke, have nothing to eat, and, you know, you're just stressing. I guess stressing is like a real deal, you know, you're stressing out.
Yeah.
But there's people like, kids starving.
Yeah, fucking, true.
You know, there's poverty everywhere. Nemo should be got the hardest, the easiest fucking poverty, G. They're just worrying about, I get it if they're like a farmer that bought their farm and they're paying it, trying to pay it off and whatnot. But if these people have had this farm in their fucking family for 150 years, bro, that farm's paid off. They're just like, you know, all they have to do is pay for these animals.
Because the guy who's still paying, these are just wars of making it harder for them.
Yeah, bro, they already got it pretty easy, and now they're coming into a hard time and they're moaning about it. There's people out in New Zealand that have it hard every single day, bro. You know what I'm saying?
You know, we're gonna have a commenter called NZ Farmer Boy, right? Yeah, he's gonna be like, fuck you.
Yeah, bro, like 100. This is my view. If you,
I didn't expect that because you
yeah, well,
you're a farmer, so
yeah. Well, and I got it, I'm gonna say it's pretty easy how I got it.
You know what's funny though is it's funny you talk about people whinging, because, and I'm not just saying this because he's in the room and we're friends, you're not a whinger though.
Yeah, unless you work with me and it's a Friday afternoon and you want to knock off early, we're all whinging boys. Yeah, I just think it's crazy.
So you think, so yeah. Yeah, like, what are you going to whinge about? You already got it pretty easy.
Yeah, yeah. They don't necessarily have it easy. I guess, like, I know in the agriculture sector, it's like the highest, or one of the highest rates, because people get stressed and...
For real?
Yeah.
I did not know that.
Yeah, there's, like, groups where people go and talk about, like, the struggle in the world, because you know sometimes you're out there by yourselves and you're dealing it by yourselves.
You just pinged the idea. We're gonna, me and Christian are gonna go around and interviewing. If you're a farmer and you want to give us an interview about this sort of stuff, let us know and we can put a mic on it. And I didn't know that. I genuinely did not know that until you just said it. Yeah. Is it that bad?
That's bad.
Man, see, I'm learning everything every day.
But I'm gonna be blacklisted from farmers. See?
You reckon?
Yeah.
Well, we hey, add it to the list.
Add it to the list.
Add it to the list. We're blacklisted from a few.
But yeah, no, I'm like, I guess if farmers have their big mortgages and stuff, but the big time farmers that, you know, own, had their farm for fucking ever. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it's been handed down to
it's
them.
It's handed like, down, and now they're coming into a bit of strife because a bit of prices have risen.
Yeah.
And now they're all not making so much profit. Or
they're watching the news one day, and Jacinda's making a tiny bit harder for them.
But then again, if you're a farmer, like, I guess other farmers that don't, like, own the land, that they're leasing it, and they're trying to got all these overheads and whatnot, like, maybe, yeah, that's hard. But in my head, you can always just walk away and just, like, if it's in your DNA, da da da, you just go find something else you love doing, you know? Or just go back to basics and be like a grunt, you know? Just, if it's that stressful, just go be a grunt and do it for nothing. Go home with no stress at the end of the day. But yeah, that's my spiel on NZ farmers.
Oh man, I honestly didn't know it was that bad.
But it's a cool industry though, I'll give them that. What do you reckon? I'll be a politician one day, G?
You'll be a terrible politician. You'll be a terrible politician because you're too honest.
Just tell them how it is.
Yeah. Like, when you're a politician, you're not supposed to tell it how it is. Mm. You're supposed to tell it how you think they want to hear it.
Mm. Make it sound like sweet music to their ears, eh?
Yeah. Mm. Sure, he hit the biggest controversial thing ever?
Yeah.
Racism?
Do you want to be racist?
No. Just
racism in New Zealand.
Yeah.
I want to put it out to the people. You know, I want to ask them, how racist do you think New Zealand is? Put in the comments 1 to 10. 10 being the racist as hell. And 1 being, okay, I'm not racist for at all. Hayden, do you get discriminated against in New Zealand for being a person of colour?
Have I been affected by racism?
Yes. Let it out, brother.
You know what?
When I look at you, I can't tell you what you are, eh? There's no tamukos on your arms, see, you got this beard, I don't know what you are.
I have like, can I say it? White boy tattoos? Like, nah, this is my whanaungatanga. This is my whanaunga tanga, G. This is my auntie. She was a Playboy model. This was my other auntie and a wolf, because she was a lone wolf.
Bro, was that Bella and Jacob?
You know what's funny? Because this arm has no meaning to it whatsoever, and this arm has meaning. Because I just wanted to put some bullshit on here, hence the Playboy bunny. But
what else you got on that one arm?
It's just the rose over here.
Rose.
You know, this space is, I'm leaving this space for Marilyn Monroe.
Oh, okay. And the rose represents what?
Nothing. None of this arm means anything. It's just a lady and a wolf.
Mm-hmm.
Playboy bunny and a rose. This arm has meaning.
The globe, bro, like, why couldn't you get New Zealand up on there, G?
Because New Zealand's not on any map. And I will get a New Zealand tattoo, and I will get a below average tattoo one day.
Bro, can you get like the North Island above your eyebrow and then the South Island below?
North Island. North Island on my forehead and just
South Island, and then the meaning to it is like, I'm the middleman of New Zealand.
Australia? you got no tattoos, right?
No tattoos, bro. I'm a saint.
You want to know the meaning of my tattoos?
Yeah, let the viewers
at actually, home. I wonder if I should.
He's been to prison.
I've been to prison. So this is my gang. You know, people, the guys that were tattooing this on me thought these were my kids' names.
Yeah, more to his cellmates.
This one's like a more serious, non-jokey one.
Yeah, because we don't have alcohol in our system.
Yeah.
We don't have alcohol in our system.
And that's it for this episode of Below Average Podcast. I can't stress this enough. We need you guys to comment. We need content. Please, we beg.
Tell us we're ugly.
Tell us we're, yeah.
That way we can be like, fucking no, you're ugly, bro.
tell us we're ugly in the comments. We'll talk about it in the next podcast.
Yeah, we'll tell you about our genetics and why we got this funny sheep nose and why my eyes look like that.
Like, comment, subscribe. But yeah, it's important you guys join in on the discussion. This is what this channel is about. It's a New Zealand podcast made for the average New Zealander. We want you guys to interact with us, comment questions. You don't agree with us, you disagree with us, it's all good. We won't censor you. By the way, fuck r/New Zealand on Reddit for permanently banning us. And r/Wellington for taking our post down. Hit us up in the comments or on our Reddit page. It's all linked down below. I'm hungover. Christian's sick. And yeah. You want to do your wink to the camera? Yeah, that's gonna be. Never take a L no more. Never take a damn.